The Azores-and-Back race is classed as the world's biggest oceanic yacht race, and it's certainly the biggest one that Britain does. It's from the UK to the Azores. The round trip is around about 3,000 miles, and the Azores are 1,200 miles off the southwest tip of Spain. The two charities I encourage people to sponsor through doing this is Shooting Star Chase, which is a charity for children's hospice in Surrey. Basically, it's for children who don't expect to make the age of 18. And 30% of it was Sail for Cancer, which is an extremely valuable charity run by my good friend Grant Preecy. Why did I enter the race? Well, it is, if you like, the most extreme sailing experience that anybody can possibly have. And I was one of 14 single-handers on the first leg out to the Azores, and one of four on the second leg back to the UK. I did four half-hour sleeps per night, which was extremely tiring. And there were certain instances like being washed out the back of the boat, having to climb back on, being held in by my harness, the sails ripping, the electronics being damaged at the top of the mast, and stuff like that. But I mean, the definition of being scared is, I think, more panic. It's frightened. Well, I was never any of those, but I was certainly worried, and I was extremely worried on a number of occasions. Very, very worried indeed. But those were all sorted out. I never ran out of options, which is the most important thing. I think you only really do get scared if you start running out of options. After day three, which was a particularly unpleasant storm overnight, I was emailed to say that I was running first in the category I was racing in, called IRC2, and I managed to maintain that for 5.5 days until the sails start spitting. That was undoubtedly one of the best bits. Other things that come to mind are the awesomeness of the huge waves, the dolphins, the flying fish, the sunsets, the whales, the sunrises, and the vastness of the scope, the 360 degrees of the stars. Approaching the finishing line was an extraordinary experience insofar as there were two parts to that. First of all, the first sight of the Azores was the most amazing experience, because they rose out of the mist like the opening sequences of Jurassic Park. Going across the finish line, I can't begin to explain how exciting that was. Without doubt, save, of course, the most salient points in your life, it would rank right up there as one of the very best moments.